Tommy.
I'm Tom Hoving.
Hello.
How are you? Good to see you, kiddo.
The artful Tommy. That's me.
Elitist, stodgy, dead. Just a few of the adjectives once used to describe New York City's Metropolitan Museum of Art. But that was before Thomas Hoving took over as director in 1967.
We made a exciting place to come to.
It really is the only institution, not only in America, but in the world, that is a balanced encyclopedia of all of the visual aspects of man's creativity.
The operative philosophy was art for the masses or art for more people than the elite.
We went back to the founders, two purposes of 1870. The people who started the Met had two goals. One, popular instruction, which meant broad instruction, and recreation. That wasn't bouncing basketballs. It was recreation, refreshment of the mind and the eye and the soul. We went back to what they wanted and opened the place up.
We caused a revolution. There were board members who were part of the revolution. There were staff who were part of the revolution. I didn't do it all, but I got all the blame. Now, as a kid, I courted my wife, we're now married 40 years, at the Museum of Modern Art. And you took your dates to the Museum of Modern Art. My goal was to have young people to take their dates to my museum, the Metropolitan Museum of Art. And that's why the beautiful steps in front of it, those great steps were done not just to have an imposing entrance to the place, but also someplace where people could gather and sit there. Lovely sunny afternoon, get to know each other and maybe come in and take a look at the art.
There's that infamous New Yorker cartoon.
That cartoon appeared in the New Yorker. When I saw it, I said, banners. We ought to have banners.
So you got the idea from the cartoon.
I got the idea from the cartoons.
First time I ever went to Egypt in Cairo. And I was there to organize the King Tut show. So I arrived and I was picked up in huge limousine and I was swept into the city. And a city that was just a gaggle of chaos, of sounds, of people hanging onto the sides of buses, and nothing working, and just thousands and thousands of people. And I loved it. And about halfway through, I said, can I get out of this car? I mean, is there another way to go? And they were terribly shocked. I said, I'd just like to walk. And I walked to Tahrir Square, where every bus in all of Egypt comes, right? Every road leads to this, right? And I got out, and I smelled the diesel fumes, and people are speaking Arabic, and they're chanting, and they're walking in galabiyas. I'm going crazy. And then I go right into the Egyptian Museum. At this point, nobody knows who I am. I haven't been met by the officials and all of this. And I walk into the galleries, and there is ramshackle city of museums. And up there in the King Tut galleries, I am face to face for the first time, 2,500-year-old things that look like they were made yesterday. And I know that they're all mine.
I first knew about you when you were Parks Commission. Before that, you had been an art historian trained at Princeton with the cloisters, I guess.
Yeah.
And then Parks Commissioner, a great photograph of you bicycling through the park was kind of a notion of the Lindsay administration. A young group of people had taken over running this city.
And I, as swinging Parks Commissioner of the City of New York, clown prince of Fun City.
You take no prisoners.
None, not even myself.
Should any government agency have any say in what art it finances?
Well, I think essentially government and art are totally incompatible. Congress is in the business of compromise. They're in the business of homogenizing things. They're in the business of supposedly of making legislation. Every censor in the history of the business has always prefaced everything by saying, I do not believe in censorship. I believe, however, in the will of the people. This congressman and others and senators would try to change the freedom of the United States, thinking that they are nearer my God than anybody
words,
else. This bozo and the other I call people who try to topple the freedoms of the United States a bozo, a clown. Tiny chip away takes away the freedom that we have fought for a lot of years.
The vast majority of the American public of every religious persuasion.
Now, you know that this? You phoned them all? Millions, 260 million?
How do we
know this?
How
do you know this?
Tom Hoving has a report.
One of the most beautiful works of art in world history was discovered, the Getty Bronze.
And I went to Munich to examine it. The rumors of its beauty had done it no justice. It was far finer than had been reported.
How would an unscrupulous person take a 500-pound bronze and get it out of Italy?
It's a question of organization.
How would you characterize your style of singing?
Very unusual.
I have no time years.
Oh, don't do that.
Get him again.
That was the question.
Now, I've heard that portrait painters are really trying to flagellate, eviscerate, deracinate, cut themselves in the tiny room. This is glass and all that sort of stuff. Is that true?
What goes on in this particular area? Why are we wearing silver suits?
Oops.
Fuel.
Now the engine.
Yep.
It's always nice to drive down the Hudson River toward the city in an airplane. There's a George Washington Bridge for visual travel. It's one of the most exciting trips anywhere in the world. Statue of Liberty looking very good. All of Manhattan laying. There's Central Park.
Now, if I had been a night watchman at the Metropolitan Museum of Art for 10 years, instead of a curator and director for 18 and a half, then you might say that my expertise is not so good. My expertise is very good.
Art, is it real?
A real work of art changes your blood pressure, makes you think, makes you laugh, or makes you frown, brings back all reminiscences of many things in your life.
Or is it fake?
Forgery is dead on arrival. It speaks nothing. It says nothing. It's not life, which is works of art, is life.
Is it good?
A riveting self-portrait, as good as any late Rembrandt. Do not miss it. It's gorgeous. It's just full of life. It's that good. Which ones do I like? All of them. On fire.
Or is it bad?
Frankly, wild horses couldn't drag me to this place, particularly in the old days. The shows were kind of...
Which is the real Tom Hogan?
And who will speak?
Up.
And who will speak? I'm not going to kiss you yet, because I want to kiss you when you finish it, all right? You get that?
Come on.